Heist, you're still unconscious. I was just going to bed. So, Donnie and pretty much everybody at this fucking casino, right?
Well, not everybody.
In on this heist. And we need to do some things. Let me check my notes here. We need to do a couple things. We need that's from Pokemon. Okay, here it is. Okay. So, we need so basically, we're doing a casino heist. We have less than 24 hours from right now before I take my 8-hour nap. Basically, there's going to be some people who are going to be feeding Carlos. We're going to be doing that, but that's a small part of it. There's also Bob, who's in charge of a different part of the plan, who's going to throw the casino into chaos, right? Okay, so that's going to happen. But first, we have 4 stages of the heist, okay? Okay, so we have 4 stages to make sure to become Carlos's feeding team and take out Carlos's old team. Then, Pam from HR is in on it, too. Pam from HR is going to fake a pay cut notice. That's how we're going to throw the whole thing into chaos. She's doing corporate spying shit. She's going to... We also got to sneak into the director's office and kill... and steal the credentials for something. Bob, who I was talking about earlier, I talked about Bob a minute ago. Bob, he works real close with the security guys. We gotta convince the security guys to give him a code. Security isn't easy to get to, though. Donnie is going to, quote, take care of things. We also have to talk to the head of delivery and the head of HR and the head of financials. No, not the head of delivery. I have that crossed out for some reason. But we also have the head of HR, and we have the head of financials. The head of financials is a mind flayer, so we gotta fucking kill that guy. But the head of HR, she's a demon. She's a bitch. And she hangs out near the bottom right to check on the employees. She's very good at her job. And her name is Viren Odom. Vivin? Is that an A? A D? Viren? What's her name?
I think it's Viren.
Viren! The head of financials is a mind flayer. Evil innate psionic powers. Does have detect thoughts. And so we gotta kill him. And I have a deck of many things. 13 level 1 stones, 5 level 2 stones, a crossbow, 160 bolts, a dagger, a holy symbol, holy water, my loot, which got upgraded, an oil flask, a potion of healing, 750,000 gold ruby, no, 7,500 gold ruby, thieves tools, 211 gold, magic hairpin, and some armor? Yeah, armor.
How'd you trade that ruby?
Crossbow? What?
I thought you traded that ruby for money.
No, I didn't do that yet. That's okay. Why Jewel didn't have any money to leave, because I didn't trade it for money yet. I still have the ruby.
Yeah, but I still have money of my own, because she won the game of a few games.
Yeah, she won a couple of the riddle games.
Yeah.
That is true. A fancy crossbow. Flame tongue crossbow. I think I have that. And
sounds
I don't think
right.
They let me have the ring.
I don't remember if they let you have the
ring. I don't think they did. I think they said no to the ring. But they let me keep the loot and the armor and the crossbow. which I'm gonna need, because we gonna kill a mind flayer. Okay. You know what? How I felt during my description of last time?
I knew there was a mind flayer and all that shit. I knew it.
Who's that guy from that show that stands in front of that board with the red string on it and he just looks fucking manic? I'll send you a meme. Hold on.
You what?
What?
That was a lot of kind of innocuous, vague information.
So I knew there was a mind flare.
My explanation of last week or from the meme?
The meme.
Fair, hold on. I'll find it.
So I wasn't losing my mind when I heard mind flare.
No, there's a mind flare.
No.
No, because I brought it up briefly, and Axel said,
I believe you're talking
about
this.
No, I didn't.
One.
I just said it wasn't the first one.
No, but I know there was a mind flayer involved. I think I said something along those lines.
Yep.
That one. Yes, I'm that one. I was that one during my explanation of what happened last week. But connected.
Oh, okay,
connected
that one. Okay. Sorry, the description that you gave was just like, what?
The guy in front of the board covered in red string that looks manic. My description was fucking spot on.
I mean, it was.
I don't think that's red string. I think that's just marker.
I think that is actually
yarn.
Red string.
No, I think
he actually only uses marker. Usually it's red string, but
yeah.
Charlie's special.
Then my mistake, I am incorrect. That is the only thing wrong with my description of what I was showing.
Yeah, it's the only thing wrong. I never said your description was wrong. I said it was innocuous and vague.
What does innocuous mean? Am I not smart enough to know that word?
I feel like most people probably don't know what innocuous means.
Remind me what innocuous means.
Not
make
harmful.
Sure I know it right.
I love you, but I think you need to stop using big words.
It means not harmful or offensive. Safe. The very safe general description.
Yeah.
Then I'm correct. I knew what it meant.
Yeah.
Who's knocking on my door? What's up?
Unless it's Santa. Santa doesn't knock.
Nah, he just breaks and enters.
And steals your milk and cookies.
Bastard, those are my milk and cookies.
Oh, please. Knowing your ass, you'll be lactose intolerant in 2 years now.
I'm playing D&D right now. Okay, love you. Sorry about that, guys.
It's all good. So, we're gonna assume that you were headed to sleep, right? I think it was around nighttime at the time.
Yeah, I was wearing my pretty red. I made my armor make it look like I had a pretty red dress on. And I was headed to find a place to sleep for the night. Wait, okay. So, Donnie and them are all sitting on the side, right? No, I'll do that in a minute. I am heading to sleep.
And what are you trying to do, Jewel?
What is Florence going to do? I'm gonna guess at some point she's gonna find out the news, but, well...
You know. RP it. Please RP it.
She's gonna... I'm not gonna hindsight it, but, you know, she's gonna go see if her stop is up, and I'm gonna guess they're going to tell her she missed the call, right?
Yep, they're going to say that you missed the call, and they will be at the same spot tomorrow at the same time. So they make their round around the country in one day.
That will notify me this time.
Well, for a small fee.
No.
For a small fee, no.
In that case, would you like to know what time your departure is scheduled for tomorrow?
Please do. Can I at least...
Yes, it should be for roughly 4 in the afternoon. It's about 7 in the afternoon. Or at night, I guess.
Oh, this is a fucking flashback.
Dear God. Hashtag and you can almost see Florence just be mentally done a little bit. Okay. I can bear. I've been in grit for that much time.
Very good. Oh shit! Sorry, I'm getting a call. One moment. Hello.
Oh God! It's happening to all of us.
All right, they didn't answer fast enough. Get about 3 seconds from me.
I wonder if does Axel cut this stuff out when we
Nope.
Like, you don't?
Not at all. I don't have time.
Nice.
If I did have time, I would, but I don't. So I don't.
Nice.
Yeah, no. So she's gonna just maybe find a nice place to sit, maybe one of the observer tables or somewhere where she's able to just sit there and observe for a hot minute.
Sure, you can definitely sit down and observe the casino.
Mm-hmm. Where are you sitting?
Would you like to passively observe or actively observe? And how long would you like to observe for?
Passively, and unless something catches her eye where she'll actually act.
So until you catch something, you're just gonna chill?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. In that case, roll a d6 for me. I will be back in just a minute.
Watching
Walking Dead.
My AC is 16. Great.
What? Nice.
No, what were you saying before that?
Oh, I was saying hooray. I would not that I have anything wrong with The Walking Dead, but I'm gonna be honest, there is some part of me that is not crazy.
Why do I have 2 damage? Who hit me for 2 damage?
Because it wasn't Florence.
It was Wedge. Wedge totally did it.
Fucking Wedge.
Yep, we all in doubt, blame Wedge. Let's do that. That's how this goes.
Wedge accepts it.
When in doubt, blame Wedge. It's always how we go.
What were you even gambling with while you were asleep?
That's for me to know and you guys to not worry about.
It does have to, I mean, could we at least be clued in on some of it? Since, you know.
Nope.
Aww.
I'm concerned.
This is entirely between Wedge and,
Can I just ask one
Dream
question?
World.
Can I just ask
Wedge
one
question? God.
Can I just ask this question?
You can ask, doesn't mean I'll answer.
Okay. Did you bet on some? Betting using your company, your party members as a wager.
Oh yeah, totally. I bet both of your souls to get mine back.
Bitch,
you're an asshole.
Did you really?
Is that news?
That's okay. All I need to do is win, and it's looking good for me so far.
Yeah, you lasted like 3 rounds against this Tarrasque.
Mildly terrified. I get to safely say I'm mildly terrified if something goes wrong.
Ah, you're fine. Probably.
Is his, like, is his body doing anything, or is it just, like, there?
Yeah, that's it.
I know, he's just chilling there. It's all in his brain.
It's all in his brain.
His mind! Alright, let's see what we got here. God damn, I forget how dangerous this thing is. What's your AC again, Michael?
Nah, oh wait,
it doesn't matter, never mind.
I was gonna say, I'm pretty sure the bonus on that thing is higher than my AC.
I think it is. I don't know why I'm rolling anymore.
Roll the one.
I think I was forgetting to roll these last couple of rounds. Or add the bonus.
I mean, there's a, I'm not good at now.
Yeah, that's fine. It's fine, it's fine. Anyway, Jewel, you rolled a 6, right?
Yeah.
So, you end up chilling there for quite a long time. But, just as, you know, you're reaching the end of your chill time, you're like, ah, this isn't worth it, whatever, I'm gonna find something to do. You just notice one of the workers acting a little strange.
Oh.
Strange as in...
Well, you can't quite put your finger on it, but you've been here for 6 hours, and so you've kind of naturally noticed how things work, right? Like, you've seen people walk here, they bring the cards there, and you passively, you can't tell why it's strange, but you can tell something is strange about this worker. It's kind of like being able to smell something, but not being able to tell exactly what you're smelling.
Can she do a perception?
Yes. Or... like I said, I'm just letting you know that near the end, you notice that this guy is kind of acting funky somehow. And now to roll for this. You know, I really should just have, before I even roll the damage, Michael, roll your will or whatever check, wisdom, fortitude, sorry, fortitude. No, wait, it's a wisdom check, not a fortitude check. My bad. Okay, reception
Axel,
of 19.
I love how you mix up 3-5 and 5-E so much.
Yeah, it's, dude.
Fortitude and wisdom. Fortitude is 3-5. Wisdom is 5-E.
Look, man, wisdom exists in 3-2. It's just not the check.
It's called willpower, yes. And
it's still wisdom. You still have a wisdom stat in 3-5.
I don't remember having a wisdom stat.
You want me to pull up the damn character sheet? It's one of the main stats.
I rolled a 16.
God damn it. All right, you did good on that one.
Ladies and gentlemen of mom and dad fighting.
No, this is dad and dad fighting. You're right.
Oh, no,
this is dad and dog fighting.
Dad and dog.
Give me back my shoes, damn it. You spit
sorry.
That paper out now.
No, it should have been uncle and dad.
Pretty much.
Now, here's my question, Axel. Did he really bet our souls?
Not at liberty to discuss that.
Given the fact that I asked the question, please humor us on that.
I mean, out of character? Maybe.
Yeah. Bitch!
Yeah, but like I said, he's a patsy!
Anyway, perception of 19, and you did good on that one. I'm gonna need you to do that 4 more times, Michael.
Oh.
Yeah. Oh. The Tarrasque makes 5 attacks a turn.
He's fighting fuck us, kindly. Oh,
bold of you to assume Carly has a soul at all.
I got 2 17s, a 14, and a 15.
Okay, so only the 14 hits. The other ones hit you, but you don't feel them. And let me do that 14, which should be the second claw attack, I believe. Which is... whoop! 30 damage.
And...
How's your health looking, buddy?
You know, despite taking 30 damage, it's actually not looking too bad because I have bludgeoning, piercing, and slashing resistance.
That's true. So technically, that would only be 15 damage.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, that's perfect in half.
Here's my question. If he dies in the spirit realm, does he die in real life?
Not really at liberty to discuss that.
What are you at liberty to discuss?
Anything liberty? That involves you two, besides the fact that if I did or did not bet your souls.
And liberty.
Yeah.
I'm at the liberty to discuss liberty. Anyway, you check the 19 is a good check. And so now you're able to really lock down what is wrong. You notice that this particular worker is wearing clothing you saw another worker wear earlier. And you see, for whatever reason, there is a tiny, tiny amount of blood on their lapel.
How long has she been sitting there?
Like, a while.
Where was I?
I thought you were sleeping.
Remember, you have to get 8 hours. Florence only needs 4. Keep this in mind.
Oh, right, okay. I'm finding a place to sleep. Right, okay. Never mind.
Florence is just like, oh, no, it's none of my business. It's none of my fucking business. I'm not getting paid. I'm not getting nothing out of it. My sanity drain. And she nopes out of that conversation. Not gonna follow that. If anything, she's just gonna pick up Ursula and just kindly just hold. Like, nope. We're not going to.
You're not gonna go look?
No. Remember, she is not necessarily good.
Carly's not good either. She's curious, though.
There's a fine line between curiosity and stupidity. As she will put it.
Okay. Not wrong. Not wrong.
Thank you.
Anyway, yeah. So that's what happened there.
Anyway, Florence will probably kindly leave that situation and go elsewhere if she can.
That's fine. Do you see that particular person has made their way out of this section of the casino?
Definitely she'll go the opposite direction.
Okay, well, they went to this boat on the right, since we're in the top left.
Let me scroll out. I'm sorry.
It's fine.
Scrolling out. Okay, now I'm good. Okay, which
so,
one?
This one to the right. They're headed that direction from roughly here.
Wait a minute. What the heck? I'm trying to see it, but it's just like...
The top gold boat.
This one.
Okay, World 20. Love you too.
Yeah, it has its issues.
Yeah, now I see it. Right there at the top one. Yeah, so she'll go to elsewhere.
Where's the sleeping boat?
There's sleeping quarters in a couple different areas.
I'm in one of them. Okay. And I would have taken Wedge's body with me.
Okay. I guess you'd probably go to the closest ones, which are here in this section, behind the exchange table. It's basically the high roller section.
I'm in here.
Yeah, so Florence will probably... Which way? Wait a minute. Got a quick question.
Yeah.
Was the person heading towards the entrance? Like, you know, where entrance and exit would be?
No. So the entrance to, like, the casino, the main entrance, the ones you guys came through, would have been the bottom left over here.
Okay. But where's the exit in this?
The exit and entrance in this are the same.
Okay.
So one in, one out, which is one of the reasons it's kind of hard to, like, sneak in and out.
That's not true. What's this back here?
Where?
Right here. Up in the very top right, left?
Yeah, that doesn't go off of the thing. That just goes to another outside section of the casino. It doesn't leave the casino.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought that's what you were talking about.
No, she's asking for the casino exit.
Maddie.
No.
Yeah.
You do know that the direction they're going is actually the direction of where Carlos is usually located. If you remember, we met Carlos on the right side of the ship.
Yeah, in which Florence is, you know, was absolutely fascinated over that. But she's not going to get herself involved in whatever. Oh, what the mess is. It's about to transpire.
Oh my god, do they feed? Never mind. Sorry.
I mean, if I remember correctly, Florence did hear the, not the whole part of Donnie's plan, but the general gist of them planning to do this, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so would she be smart enough to go out on a limb to guess that that's what this goes towards?
She could make that connection if she'd like, I guess.
I mean, sure. Do you want me to roll for it, or just no?
You shouldn't. I mean, that's kind of a basic deduction.
Yeah.
You know, just connecting so information, under, you know?
Yeah, I'm just asking, because, you know. Falls under. Just didn't know if you were gonna fall have it under intelligence or.
I feel like that one's more wisdom than intelligence. In that intelligence is the knowledge of facts, and wisdom is the application of that knowledge. So the best example of that one is always the
tomato,
yeah, in the fruit salad, and a bard can sell you that fruit salad.
So she's just going, she remembers it, but she probably would put two and two together?
I would assume so. You have a fairly high wisdom and intelligence, don't you?
I have a high intelligence. The wisdom is at a 12.
That's still above average in combination with your intelligence. That should be fine.
Okay. So, yeah, no, she's gonna go the other way direction.
I'm wiser than Florence.
Florence is smarter enough not to to walk away from a crazy hell-raising that's come. I mean, disagreeably,
yeah, but you missed out on the cool room that Carly is in.
In which Florence is like, okay, have fun with that.
You don't know where she is?
No, but she can always ask. But does she feel like it? Not really.
Man, you ain't no fun.
Florence ain't no fun.
You can fail the Florence.
Florence is kind of a stick in the mud.
Yeah, right?
I know that she's the stick in the mud. There's a reason why there's a joke that was made and which I'm not repeating.
I will make it clear. Carly's on the bed, Wedge is on the floor.
Oh, of course. We know
this. That's only because he's a mummy right now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And you're a dead mummy, so like.
Not dead, unconscious.
Dead unconscious.
Oh!
Is almost a dead mummy. Anyway, with that being said, you reach the halfway point of the night where 4 hours of sleep would have passed for Carly.
Eight.
At this point, Wedge is actually finally fully healed or recovered as far as natural resting goes. But he doesn't wake up for whatever reason, unknown to you guys.
I mean, he's with Carly, not Florence. And Florence is just probably wandering around away from what seems to be a troublemaker.
Now, question, did I know that Florence just fucked off somewhere? Do I know that she's still on the
What's your passive perception again?
My passive is...
Carly's, yeah.
14.
Yeah, you should have noticed. Unless she snuck off.
I would have grabbed her and told her to follow.
Nope. For what reason?
So you can sleep? Duh.
I mean, I need.
Well, listen.
Sleep.
I have this cool room, and I'm paying for it.
Quick reminder too that to what's the word again? To gain affinity with a magic item, you do require a period of time equal to a rest period attuning with it.
Oh,
or an hour or something.
Meant for the item.
Yeah.
Carly. Yeah, okay.
I believe it's supposed to be a short rest worth. So
yeah.
It's supposed to be like 4 hours.
I think it's that. It's either a short rest or...
No, it is a short rest. Or no, wait a minute. Let me go check.
I'm trying to remember the exact...
You want to
look? I believe attuning to an item takes 4 hours. So short rest. Where where you have to be focused on the item.
It does, aww, I think, actually technically count as rest, though. I'm not 100% sure.
Oh, that's not as rest?
I think it does. I don't think it doesn't count as not rest.
No, it's a short rest. My bad. It is a short rest. Which can be a very short period. It could be up to it. A minimum short rest is like an hour, if I remember correctly.
That's why I thought there was a time in between it.
Believe me, I've had an hour of rest, and I can tell you after an hour of rest, you are groggy and irritable as fuck.
That's because you took sleep and not a nap.
That's only what I take. So, wait, what do I have to attune to then? So I have to attune to my armor, do I need to attune to my crossbow?
I don't remember if you have to attune to that particular item type. You had the flame tongue, right? Or was it the... What was your one again?
I do believe flame tongue requires attunement.
I do believe so.
I don't think the armor needs attunement, though.
I don't think it does. But flame tongue does require attunement.
Yeah. Yes.
What about my fancy loot that does a whole bunch of shit?
Ooh, that one probably definitely requires attunement.
So 2 hours... I would need like 2 hours to look at my fancy loot and look at my crossbow. Just really looking at this crossbow, it's really interesting, really cool crossbow.
It's not necessarily looking at it as much as communing with it.
Mm-hmm. I'm talking to my crossbow.
Pretty much.
Okay, so here's what will happen, right? I'll see Florence there, right? And I'll say, I'll just be talking to my crossbow for some reason. I'll be in there. You should come with me when you're ready to sleep. And then I go in. I do not wait for an answer.
Okay.
Fair.
And then I go into my little room. I have Wedge on the floor. And while I'm looking at it, I will kick my feet up on Wedge and, like, use him as a footrest.
Yeah, no, you need to attune to the whole...
You're not conscious, you don't know!
Oh gosh.
And Mike is there, and I'm giving him scritches while I am talking to my crossbow and loot.
That is a 2 hour. Oh gosh, that is gonna be the funniest 2 hours for Florence. Because she's resisting.
If you were in there, would be funny for you, wouldn't it?
Oh, yeah. But yeah, that is funny. That would be the image of the year.
If only you were here. Mm-hmm. But anyway, that's 4 hours. Right, 4 hours.
Yeah.
It's a short rest, if I remember. For both of them, yeah.
So I'm 2 hours. I spent 2 hours looking at my crossbow and loot, and then I went to sleep, and I'm 2 hours asleep, and now it's now.
You need 8 hours of sleep. Remember, Carly's a half elf.
Well, wait. Axel just said it's 4 hours from last episode. So is it 4 hours or is it 6 hours, Axel?
Yeah. Sorry, it would have been 6 by the time that she reaches that thing. So you will have hit your attunement point before Jewel interacted and saw that worker.
Okay.
But it is currently 6 hours after.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so you need to come sleep.
I mean, it's fine, I'm just saying. I'm not trying to be a smarty, I'm just saying.
Yes, you are.
Sure, I'm just trying to make sure I'm understanding how much time is left.
Yeah. Also, quick reminder, person can only be attuned to 3 magic items at a time.
I only have two.
I know.
If my armor doesn't need attunement, then I only have two.
I don't believe so. What's your armor again?
Studded leather that changes what I look like, or what my outfit looks like.
Oh, you have the shit. What is that?
I think I know which one she's talking about.
I couldn't find it on D&D Beyond.
What?
It's like glamored armor.
Yeah, glamored.
Glamored studded.
Yep, glamored, that's it. I couldn't remember the term, but yeah, it's glamored armor.
Yeah, no, that does not need a attunement.
Nope. Anybody can use that.
Then I only have two. Yep. My loot and my crossbow.
Yep.
I'm gonna go talk to my fucking crossbow.
I just wanted to make sure that was the thing. So we don't...
Yeah.
Stand it.
Wonk.
Do I feel any different from Wedge losing?
You said Wedge lost.
He put down. He was battling a terrorist, whatever.
In his mind. Mind is a powerful place.
All right.
Also a weird
anyway,
place.
I'm asleep. I'm sleeping.
Alrighty. What about you, Jewel?
I mean, she only needs 4 hours, so why not get those 4 hours after seeing the chaos ensued? I'm gonna need the rest.
Well,
I come into my room.
Most likely.
Yeah.
So,
but before doing that, she's gonna make sure she has her stuff probably promptly packed away from Carly's stuff.
So, to give us a slow timeline of events to explain how things have happened. At roughly, 5-ish o'clock. Right around the time when Donnie was breaking down the plan, the train actually arrived where it was supposed to be, or whatever, the casino. It came to its stop late. It's supposed to get there at 4 every day. Doesn't mean it always does get there at that time every day. Then, following that, you have the short period of time where Jewel was kind of asking things before going to, you know, do her sitting and observing for 6 hours. And at that same time, we have Carly going to do her attunements. So, with that, your first attunement time would have ended at 9 at night.
What?
Well, it would have been 5 p.m. to 9 p.m.
I thought it was a short rest.
Is a short rest not 4 hours?
No, I thought it was 1 hour.
Yeah, that's what I said. It's a short rest is minimum 1 hour.
Minimum.
I don't know. Jeez. She can take the minimum. There's nothing that says that it can't.
I'm sorry.
Because I would feel so silly talking to my crossbow for like 7 hours. That would be silly.
I mean, it sounds like a Carly thing to do.
She's going to talk to her loot for an hour and a half, and then she's going to get sleepy.
Yeah.
Hello?
Sorry, I'm just checking something.
No problem. I just thought I cut out, because I do that sometimes.
Yeah, no, you didn't cut out.
That's right, that's why it works that way. Okay. I was trying to remember their system for 5e. Anyway, so you are allowed to take 1 hour for each of those attunements, because you'll need to do one each.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't believe either of them have any specific time. You just have to use a full short rest time period.
I'm gonna use an hour and 15 minutes to talk to my loot.
Okay.
So I'm more attuned with my loot.
Yeah, there you go. And so now we are at 7 o'clock. And you can decide to rest, sleep, or do whatever else you want.
Hmm. What time should Wedge wake up?
Technically,
what time did he pass out?
Technically, he was passed out the entire time. From the time you guys
got there. But, like, when did we get here?
Oh, I don't know. Probably, like, noonish.
So he should be waking up any time.
Yeah. Sure. Okay.
I'm gonna poke him. Does he do anything? I'm gonna poke him. I'm gonna poke him again. But, like, harder this time.
You can go for it.
Poke him. Poke, 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 poke.
You feel
like right on the tip of the nose.
You feel a cold, decrepit, rot, well, not really rotting anymore, mummy.
Gross.
Yeah.
Is he, like, alive, Mike, do you think?
I mean...
I say too, Mike.
How the fucking mono drone.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You just hear the shame. How do they hear this far?
And then even
they're always further, listening.
And then even further off in the distance, you hear Mike.
Jesus.
Once again, you just need a big enough group of mono drones that it never stops.
Yeah.
Okay,
it's like a wave.
Unfortunately, Mike, you're going to be taking a little bit.
Oh, yeah.
A little bit. I mean, you got your resistance.
Uh-huh.
What happens, Mike, if I put a healing spell into Wedge? What happens, do you think?
Mike. Shame.
He's not even any fun like this. He's not, like, responding to any of my pokes.
Yeah, that reminds me.
Like, you'd think he'd give me something, because I'm bored, and he's, like, entertaining, at least.
Oh, yeah.
And the way Dot is saying, oh yeah, is just confusing me. I lay down on the bed. And as I'm about to sleep, I wake up and I look at Mike and I say, when he wakes up, Mike, don't let him leave without waking me up. And then I'm gonna make him stay. Okay. And then I go to sleep.
Okay, then. So we're going to assume that now it's roughly 7:30, right? Give or take? Maybe
about
7:30. So you're going ahead and go. Are you taking a long rest or a short rest?
Well, I said I needed my 8 hours because I need to get my spells.
I just wanted
back
to be sure, you know, because that could just be a turn of phrase.
See, now I'm nervous.
Why?
Because you. So with one last look around, can I look around the room? Is there anything weird about the room? Is the room real?
Gosh darn it, Axel, you've started this chaos, and now you know. Son of a gun, dang it, you've done your job as a DM of instilling paranoia.
That was really all I wanted from this adventure. Everything after that is just gravy.
Of course, you enjoy it.
Is the room real? What do I roll for that? I'm going to investigate the room. Ooh, 17, so 21 total.
Okay, so you're investigating the room, 21?
Yeah.
You notice that there is a lot of magical surveillance equipment in these rooms.
Of course. That's it?
What were you looking for? To see if it's real?
I want to see if it's real. Ooh, and can I see if there's anything, like, cool left behind by whoever was in here last?
Yeah, there's a lot of looking. All right, fine. Just because you rolled good.
Yay. What the fuck is the statue here? What is that?
What does what do?
The statue. Why is there just a dragon head in my room?
It's a literal mounted dragon's head.
Is it like a real dragon?
Yeah, it's a real mounted dragon head.
I'm gonna take that when I leave. Dang.
Okay. We'll just take the 10-foot head.
Oh, it's 10 feet? Well, okay.
It's a
dragon's
head.
I'm stuck on these tables.
Look how big it is compared to your character.
Listen, I want it, though.
I'm not saying you can't have it.
Linda, listen.
Listen, Linda. Thank you. I wonder, okay, are any of the teeth loose? Wait, there's magical surveillance in here? Is it like looking surveillance?
That would require an arcana check.
I want to see if the teeth are loose.
So, are
any of the teeth loose?
Oh, I mean, kind of. Some of them look a little looser than others.
I'll try to wiggle one. I did not even hear the results of my investigation. First, I want to hear the results.
For your investigation of the room?
Yeah.
So, you had seen that it looks pretty real. You seem to think there's some magic surveillance equipment around. But you would have to do an arcana check to see exactly what kind. You notice the dragon head, obviously. Got a nice big couch. And then there is a table. And on it is just a deck of cards.
Oh, I want to play with the deck of cards. I want to fiddle with them. I want to look at them.
Okay.
What's up with the cards?
You're going to have to do a check on that, won't you?
Ooh, new check. New check.
Well, I guess it's either an investigation or probably an investigation.
Investigation. 19.
You don't know exactly what this is, but you do see that they look very similar to the cards that you have.
Ooh, my deck. I'm not going to pull a card if they look similar to my deck of many things. Okay, I want to arcana check the room to see what kind of surveillance I'm under.
Okay. Go ahead and roll your arcana.
Not with an 8. You know, probably I think not. It's kind of magic in here. Might be kind of magic, you guys.
It could be a bit magic in this bitch.
Mm-hmm.
Magic all up in that area, in this area, right over here. Magic!
Yeah.
So much magic.
So I'm going to then tell Mike, I'm going to say, Mike, if anyone comes in, that's not Florence. Kill them. No, not really. Don't actually kill them, Mike. That would be bad.
Mike?
Just wake me up. Just let me know. Just let me know. And then I lay down and go sleep.
Alrighty, so you're going for that full hour, 8 hours, right?
Why you keep asking?
Because I need to know, because it determines how much healing you get.
Okay.
Duh! You always have to say that. What do you mean? Every time you go to rest, you have to define it as a short or a long rest.
Axel's making me scared.
You're silly.
I'm scared. I will take my 8 hours. Ooh, all
right, let's see how I do on this. I have to keep Michael in a precarious position. It shouldn't be too damn hard, but I can fail it. Son of a bitch!
Did you fail?
Yes! All right, you got out, you bitch.
Yay!
Now it's his turn again.
Yeah.
Anyway.
So I think you know what you need to do.
So in short, there's terrorizing. Lots and lots of terrorizing.
Look, I'm not terrorizing anything. Maybe.
You're not terrorizing currently.
No.
Axel is.
That's not me. I don't terrorize anyone.
Yeah, that's my there's my answer. I hear a disagreeing clause. Answer or clause, whichever one makes it better.
I'm eating my breadsticks and pizza, so you can go about your business. I'm sleeping for 8 hours.
I was gonna say, what is Florence ready to do with Ursel?
I mean, let's see. After the sightseeing, seeing the shit about to go down, I'm gonna guess on a limb she's just gonna. I mean, she was notified that, you know, Carly was willing to at least share the bunker up with her for the whole. At least.
I think she said that she had told you that, right? She tried to retcon that in there.
Yes, I did.
That's what I thought I heard too. So that's what Florence will do probably after the events of the first bit of the 6 hours. So, for the most part, Florence probably eventually make her way to the resting area, specifically where Carly would be, and probably walk into a quite a sight.
I mean,
or would they?
It's just a room with a dragon's head and a sleeping body of Wedge and an awake Mike.
Which, Florence will kindly wave to Mike.
Mike? Mike.
Carly is snoring.
Yeah. Which Florence. Sadly, I don't understand. Florence is gonna see. Oh, okay. Any chance Florence can do this? Like, ritual wise.
Yes, magic is allowed inside of those sleeping quarters.
Okay, so that's that. She'll do, try to. And she'll ask Mike to repeat it again. What he's.
My fair maiden, how are you? It is an interesting and wild time in which we live. There will be many days of which turmoil come to pass, I fear. Protect and guard your own self, as you must always do.
In which Florence will kind of nod to let her be known, let it be known. Saying, but probably can't respond in the same. Well, I'm doing good. Kind of stop, but I'm good. For the most part, Florence is gonna probably find a comfy spot for herself after, you know, making sure things are kindly secured.
Oh god, Jesus Christ, I hit the wrong button like 3 times. No one wants to see the code console. Oh, whoops.
Probably, I think after that, probably, before nodding off, she'll probably thank the mic for being, you know, a caring,
You are most welcome, kind maiden. I appreciate your thoughtful words as we fly across the sky in this living perpetual hell I have been forced to accompany. However, you are the one bright ray of sunshine in my life of servitude.
Yes.
What? I gave him torches earlier.
Keep in mind, Florence understands it because of a freaking spell. And she's enjoying the living shit out of enjoying the fact that Florence will probably not...
Oh, I guess I should have told Florence about the card deck that's still in the middle of the table, unless Ashley pocketed that. Okay. Just want to be sure.
What was it? Oh, wait. Nah.
Why is Florence a coward?
Cowards live to fight another day.
That's the thing, though. Cowards don't fight.
Yeah.
This proves my point.
And by the time a coward does fight, they're no longer considered a coward.
Cowards fight all the time. What do you think being brave means? You gotta fight your cowardice. You can't be brave if you're not afraid of anything. Cowards are the bravest of us all.
No.
Look, it's not my
fucking logic on me.
It's not my fault that's the way English is written. It doesn't work that way in other languages, only English. In Spanish, you literally possess fear. It's like an item you have. It's not like it's like hunger. You don't say, I am hungry. You say, I have hunger. Very interesting language.
Yeah, no. It's accurate. I'm not even going to argue that because, shoot, I already know the answer to that.
That one is an interesting one. But it's one of those ones that I always found it funny because it's literally like a oxymoron.
Mm-hmm. It is.
How can one be brave without being afraid? But you can't have bravery. Alright.
Anyway, yeah. Florence will at least wish the Modron good night. Or at least 4 hours of sleep for her.
I don't even know if Modrons sleep.
They're constructs, if I remember correctly, right?
So yeah, I don't think they sleep. He's just gonna sit there and watch you creepily. I mean...
Creeper...
As creepily as it is.
I mean, Florence is... In Florence's case, she's wearing traveler's clothes, so what the heck could go wrong? It's not like she's parading around in the gown. It's one thing if she was parading around in that gown any further. Yeah, that would be creepy looking down.
Carly's wearing a really cool red dress.
Yeah. But also, darn well, Florence knows that this, that's not a legitimate red... I'm not saying it's not a legitimate red dress, but she knows that it's armor, actually. Lambert armor.
Fair.
So she knows it's not an entirely a full-on dress.
You're keeping me warm!
Who says the traveler's clothes aren't keeping her warm?
To be fair, I mean, you guys are in a suite, so... I'm hoping the suite's well heated. At least if I'm getting my money worth.
Hell yeah.
Hell yeah. Mm-hmm. Anyway. Basically, you go well, first I guess we'll do Florence. She goes her 4 hours of sleep and receives her full rest time and appropriate healing and refills.
Mm-hmm. Which isn't much since she didn't use many as it is.
Oh shit. I think I timed this just right.
Just right.
So what do we got? Fuck.
Do I sleep? Florence slept.
She gets up earlier than you, so she has 4 hours.
I thought she came in 4 hours after I went to sleep.
Because remember, it was 6 hours people watching.
She should have come in, sorry, so she should have... Because did you go to sleep immediately after getting back in? I thought you went to sleep at 7.
Yeah, because, okay, so...
So that would have been 2 hours in. And then you started your 4 hours.
Yeah.
Actually, yeah, okay, I see
what you're
saying.
Yeah.
Yeah, because I'm thinking...
Oh, you guys are actually right. You're definitely right.
Yeah.
So you guys should be waking up at roughly the same time. Technically,
that's never happened before.
Technically, Carly would wake up slightly earlier because of the travel time into the room, etc.
Mm-hmm.
And
it's like 3:30 in the morning.
Michael, oh wait, okay, so I actually did that wrong. So we'll do that. Yeah. Okay, so.
I'm just stretching. Saying hello to 3:30 in the morning. Carly is now sitting back up, and she has her feet rested on Wedge again, like a footrest, and she is reading the book.
Meanwhile, Florence wakes up, stops for a moment to see Carly has turned Wedge into a footrest. As much as she's smiling and laughing, she's just like, okay, I think I see. I miss some good humor.
Morning, Blinkyhead.
Morning, Mike. And she also waves to the Modron. It's like, morning to the nice Modron, too.
Mike. Forgot, how long does that spell last?
Oh, no, it was an hour.
Okay.
It's world.
I just gotta be sure, because some spells last a day.
Oh, no, that one. So she, I'm guessing she would know that she can only probably get an hour in before.
Yeah, she would know. I just don't remember off the top of my head for that one.
Mm-hmm.
So, Michael, how you looking?
I hate that chuckle.
you know, I haven't tallied it all, but I'm fairly certain I've got you.
You're done, fuck.
I mean, I could be wrong. Yeah, I thought so. I fucking thought so.
My luck finally ran out.
A little bit. He'd been running a good roll, actually.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Considering I lasted how many rounds against that Tarrasque?
Probably like 5 or 6. I want to say. To be fair, I will say I think the first couple rounds I was not doing certain things right. It, on both ends, for me and you, I was like not adding my modifiers, and I wasn't really looking at the armor class or the terrace.
Oh yeah, no, Tarrasque will help me. Yeah, leave that alone.
They got a pretty big one, especially when you consider they're basically goddamn magic proof.
Mm-hmm. I mean, the only way you're really gonna kill one as a mage is if you're like doing AoE attacks. And that's if you don't mind friendly fire.
I cast fireball. But the room, I didn't ask how big the room is. I said I cast fireball.
Explosion!
But yeah, no, that's the thing. So,
hey, here's a question. Mm-hmm. Florence. Mm-hmm. this chocolate fuck was asleep, like, for at least, 8 hours. When I went to sleep 8 hours ago.
I mean, roughly, we've been on here for almost roughly a little bit past 24 hours, right?
Not at this point, no, because you would be, let's see, what time did you start your 8-hour rest?
It's 3:30 in the morning.
Yeah, so you're roughly probably 18 hours in, I think, or 20, no, because you got there around a little before noon, probably around 11. Pimps don't wake up early.
Of course.
Axel speaks from experience.
You keep saying that, you're going to get me fucking arrested.
So why is he not awake yet? Is my question.
Bonk. Oh no, I didn't put the thing right.
I mean, I could check, but then again, I've never dealt with a mummy as a medical client. I mean,
let's check. We're gonna check together.
Oh, sweet.
And I'll just be sitting there poking him, trying to wake him up.
Oh my gosh. Is there any chance she can get some input from the Modron?
My medicine is +3.
I know. But Florence can do that comprehend language as a ritual again, and for goodness sake, see if it has some input to give.
How long does your ritual take?
10 minutes.
Yeah.
While she's sitting there doing her 15-minute ritual, I'm just going to be 10, like...
10, not 15. 10-minute.
Her 10-minute ritual. Okay. I'm just going to be sitting there, like, braiding Wedge's hair.
Oh my gosh. Florence was really trying not to laugh her behind up while watching, while doing the thing. Or at least Russell's not trying to laugh.
The amount of typing Axel is doing, it makes me uncomfortable.
Oh, don't doubt it. It's definitely making me uncomfortable as well, because shit goes wrong, we're all fucked.
Yeah.
And we don't know what the reason, except Michael did something stupid. Anyway. So I'm just waiting for the AOK from Axel, and roughly that.
I don't even know if Maiku knows that I'm braiding Wedge's hair.
If that is the case, it's gonna be the funniest thing to wake Wedge is gonna wake up to.
Yeah. He's just gonna she's just gonna wake up to just like braids all over his hair.
And Wedge is all of a sudden going to sit straight up quickly.
I stand corrected.
Well, that sucked.
Get back here so I can finish braiding your hair. What happened?
I'd rather not talk about it.
I'm gonna keep braiding. Your hair is in my hands right now. I could pull it. Tell me what happened.
Don't
and I keep braiding.
With a good time.
I'm trying not to sound smartass after that 10 minutes marker.
No. Well, you mentioned Wedge's hair because you're braiding it and he's not answering you. So,
I know. That's why
I snorted. I tried to look serious for a minute and then I snorted. And then I said, okay, now tell me what happened. And I'm just braiding.
Let's see where this entry ended. God, there's so much to look through.
I'm laughing because after that 10 minutes is gonna go by, Florence is just like, really?
Carly full on, when he sat straight up, I full on screamed.
I like that.
Was that during any time during that 10 minutes? Or I swear this is gonna be funny.
Yeah, it was. It would have been pretty much nearly exactly as you had cast the spell, Wedge would have woke up.
In which, Florence is gonna kind of look in Carly's direction. What? And she sees Wedge fully awake. Well, it's nice to see. I would say I was going to have to check to see if you actually had a pulse, but that is going to be a different.
Ooh, do you? Carly checks. She's just like touching his neck right on his jugular. Do you have a pulse?
Oh my gosh.
I'm going to assume you feel no pulse.
Creepy!
Given what I know about mummies, I'm pretty sure you don't feel a pulse.
Creepy! Now tell me what happened. And I keep braiding. You're gonna have a very intricate braid.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Florence is gonna just be sitting away from. Just for the record, Florence kind of says while she's inching away, I have not braided. I have not touched your hair.
It was her idea.
No, it was not my idea.
It was absolutely
somebody else's idea.
Really? Do you think I would actually do that?
I don't know. You seem childish enough.
You can't. I would say that ask the Mondrone, and he would tell you, but don't think he can tell you.
Wedge looks at the Mondrone. Shame!
No! And she flicks him on the shoulder. Be nice.
Piece of flesh flies off.
Gross. Tell me what happened.
I may have bet your souls to try to win mine back and lost.
You did what now? I'm sorry, say again. And best be telling me you're joking.
Did I stutter? I said I bet your souls to get mine back and I lost. In all fairness, I did last like 5 rounds against the Tarrasque.
Do I feel any different?
Mike is going to say you probably didn't lose.
Oh, good.
At least not right away, it seems like.
Carly doesn't know he said that. And so, she's like, slaps his arm and is like, tell me you're fucking joking.
Oh, good.
Bitch, I might be, bitch, I might not be.
Don't call me a bitch. And I keep, like, slapping his arm. Don't call me a bitch. Tell me you're wrong. Tell me you're lying.
Florence is gonna sit here and let this app run its course for a good few minutes before actually chiming in of what Mike actually said.
Tell me you're lying. Tell me you're lying. Best not of. Best not of. Are you lying?
I cannot tell you I'm not lying.
While this is going on, can Florence and the Modron just have a sheer look at before just looking back at these two?
Sure, yeah. Mike doesn't mind.
Mike. Should we tell, should I just speak up sooner or just let this keep going?
Mike kind of shrugs and then just, like, laughs. I thought you were arguing with him.
I am, but I have ears, too.
And she kind of points to the Modron. I can understand what he's saying with that lovely ritual. At least for an hour.
Now, real quick question. Do I actually feel any different?
I guess you'd have to make a perception check on that, wouldn't you?
My self-perception.
English is hard.
I keep trying to say perception. Now, you'd think that... Can I get advantage on that? Because, you know, I'm like...
Checking yourself, huh? Yeah, you know, we'll give it to you. Fine.
Cool, because that was a 3.
But, here's the thing. How are you going to tell if your soul's missing?
Do I feel any different was my question.
Okay, here's the thing. Did Sam feel any different when he lost his soul when he was pulled back out of hell in Supernatural?
Sorry, you thinking about Supernatural to me? I fucking hate Supernatural. Do not talk to me about Supernatural. 21.
Get the fuck out of here. Get the fuck out of here.
Get the fuck out of here with that Supernatural. Supernatural did not end six seasons when it should have. It stayed 6 years too long. 21.
Look, you might be right about that, but I will not have your slanderous facts spoken here. Your factual slander has no place here.
Meanwhile, Florence is just sitting and watching this shit go on because... Florence is gonna ask, how do you guess that he's bullshitting, though?
You see Carly and Wedge arguing about Supernatural, and then randomly Carly just says, 21.
And
what, are we playing blackjack now?
Clearly.
Earlier they were.
Yeah, I mean.
Lose that too. I feel any different?
That's okay, I only lost your souls.
Do I feel any different though?
What did you roll?
The Modron a question, like, how do you know he's bullshitting at this point?
Well, for a couple reasons. One, when you bet on the house with other people's things, you become a debtor. Debtors can't leave the Dreamsino.
Ah.
So the fact that he's here heavily suggests that he is no longer in debt. But I don't know what his competition was. I don't know what he did in the Dreamsino.
Yeah, no, that's accurate. But I just have to ask because, you know, he just blurted out something that probably should warrant some level of concern, right?
I mean, yes and no. Casino is an open kind of place. But also a closed kind of place.
Well, at least the news I'm hearing at least is a little bit nice.
Worry not, fair maiden, for if your soul had come under peril, I, the Modron Mike, would assist you in reclaiming it.
Aw, that's nice.
And just
you mean the same Modron that causes all the other Modrons to start yelling shame.
You just hear from outside, shame, 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 Mike. They are jealous of my exceptional vernacular and my gleam of superiority. Then he looks down sad anyway.
Sandwich, and Florence kind of pats him on the back, like, you poor.
And he just actually says Mike.
Poor Wait, Mike.
Yeah. So, what was your role again for trying to see?
21.
So, you don't really feel any different.
So, and Florence is gonna kind of say, are you two done arguing back and forth, or you want me to put my input in, or what directly. I heard from
I'm gonna punch
mic.
Wedge's arm. I'm gonna punch Wedge's arm and then say, go ahead, Florence.
He's gonna translate minus the extra bit about the, you know, mic extra tidbit fact. She's gonna explain what the gist of it is. Of him bullshitting, essentially. And why it would probably be bullshitting.
You lied to me.
How do we know the Modron's telling the truth?
I mean, right now, the Florence kind of looks at the Modron and then looks back at Wedge. I mean, one of you haven't... The Modron clearly here hasn't tried to stab me.
So you're just hoping he didn't try anything.
He did.
Here's the thing, though. You're the only one who can understand the Modron, so how do we know you're not just holding your grudge against me and relaying false information?
I feel fine.
So if I'm bullshitting, what I just did for the past 10 minutes was not real, right, Carly?
It could possibly have all been fake. We don't know.
Do I look like a wizard?
But she would probably recognize what the heck. What would be
I mean, I'm, I know a ritual when I sees it.
But did you actually see the ritual? You were braiding my hair.
I braided your hair. Your braid took like 2 minutes. How fancy of a braider do you think I'm going to waste on you?
I don't know. You sat there and said you were still braiding my hair quite a few times. A lot more than what would be consistent of a 2 minute braid.
See, he's just being such a meanie.
I'm going to punch his arm again. Stop being a jerk!
What did I do? See,
he not you.
Then recovered from it, but it damaged his eye permanently.
What?
Talking about The Walking Dead.
Oh, okay. I thought you were talking about Wedge, and I was like, what the fuck? I punched your arm!
Yeah, you punched my arm, and all of a sudden I have permanent eye damage. Because correlation.
The eye bone's connected to the arm bone! Wedge, okay, Wedge. What really happened, Wedge? If you tell me the truth, Wedge, I pick up the cards off the table. I will give you these cards.
I don't want those cards.
Why don't you want these cards?
Why?
They're my cards.
Why would I want them?
Because they're mine, and I'll be sad to not have them.
Makes a good point.
What good does that do me?
Suffering.
You're weird, and you like suffering.
Only of select people?
Oh,
I'm of select people?
And you just hear Florence say, well, thanks. At least I know the Modron is much nicer than you, too.
You deserved it. You stole my shit. At least I thought you stole my shit, so I stabbed
you. Who stole your shit? I literally stole your shit!
Yeah, but at the time, I didn't know it was you. I thought it was her, so she deserved it. How would you give it back?
You're so weird. Okay, but like, for real, what happened? Like, for real.
I fought in an arena.
And? Do you have your soul back? Are you still a mummy?
I won 2 rounds.
What does that mean?
Mike!
I won 2 rounds.
That Mike statement, does Florence here know what that means or just...
Yeah, she does. One sec.
Okay.
So, honestly though, like, what did you win? If you lasted 2 rounds.
I didn't ask what I won for lasting 2 rounds. Because I lost the 3rd round.
What did you lose for the 3rd round?
Oh, okay.
But what did you lose for losing the 3rd round?
Nothing.
Wedge.
It was just for fun.
Wedge. This is a casino, Wedge. They don't do anything for fun.
Florence kind of chimes in. Each round is a bet.
Oh.
So if he lost a round, he either lost double his winnings or just lost a round of winning.
Oh. But you won twice, so what did you win? You didn't ask what you won?
I didn't exactly have a chance.
You set up the parameters of a bet before you enter the bet, you stupid! And I flick his forehead.
More flesh falls off.
You're disgusting! You're falling apart!
Well, I'm a fucking mummy, and you're hitting me!
What the fuck is that? I'm not hitting you, I'm flicking you! When I hit you, you'll know!
Mike.
enjoying the fact that she's not even actively fucking making this mess.
Mike.
Yeah, that is true. Thankfully, but, like, I'm not mean like that. Evie, you can ask
Russell. Then what did you lose the third round? What do you do?
Florence is just kind of, you're just hearing her kind of talk for a bit before she kind of holds Ursel, like, probably very sleepy, but it's just, yeah.
Are you holding him like a baby? That's so cute.
Yeah.
That's so cute.
Yeah.
What did you lose for losing the third round?
Nothing that concerns you.
Everything concerns me. We're a party.
I mean, we may be a party, but it don't concern you.
Wedge.
Carly.
Wedge, come on, I braided your hair. Wedge, come on.
Florence is just watching. Florence and Carly, Florence is just watching these two happen. Every now and then.
No.
But idly asks about a little bit about the event that Wedge participated in the Melodron. Like, passively, like, it's curiosity of what the event's like. Or at least the premise of it.
Mike.
What it'll cost.
Or
what'll it cost me?
Yeah, roughly as well as what can be, it can and can't be betted.
No, I mean, like, I'm talking to Wedge right now. What will it cost me?
Cost you?
Mm-hmm.
For what?
What will it cost me? To know.
I don't know. What's the value of knowledge?
Let me look.
What, better yet, what's the value of worthless knowledge?
Let me look.
In which Florence kind of pipes up, there's no such thing as worthless knowledge.
Donald Duck was banned in Finland because he doesn't wear pants. How's that for useless knowledge?
That is a very useful piece of socioeconomic context on Finland's culture and economy.
It was either in the 1970s or 1980s where a Russian cargo plane was flying over a river and dropped a live cow and sunk a boat.
I bet you that was important information to that boat.
Yeah.
They would have really liked to know about that ahead of time.
Yeah.
I pull out a crossbow. I pull out a crossbow. And I sit it on the ground in between us. It's not my flame tongue, are you kidding? It's my old one. I set it on the ground in between us.
Okay.
I'll give it to you. For the knowledge.
I have no need of it.
It's a crossbow. You died once because you get all up in things business. You have arrows. I forgot.
Uh-huh. I'm not gonna take a crossbow which has infinitely, pretty much infinitely, less range than a longbow.
Infinitely less range than a longbow.
I mean, let's see, you hit something at 600 feet with a fucking crossbow.
Just use meteor swarm! And then, you know, like, throw a bow into it. It'll get there.
Oh, wow. Axel.
I take out my oil flask, and then I put that in the ground in between us, and I say, this oil flask is not just full of oil, Wedge. This is full of holy oil. With what we're going to fight, that'll be really helpful. I'll give it to you, so you can coat your little arrows in it. If you tell me.
I didn't lose anything really important.
But what is it? What'd you lose?
I can't remember. What was I bet?
I was waiting for him to, like, remember what he actually did.
Shit, I can't scroll up that high.
Yeah, you have to. I went and looked. So the bet was basically your soul for your life.
Ah.
Although, relatively speaking, there were some nuances to that as the house decides the value of all of the betting materials. Especially in more contextual situations like that. If I remember correctly, you had borrowed a loan as well on a couple people's souls.
Which was an utter lie, actually.
Yeah, it was. You didn't actually do that. I just like to fuck with you guys. But,
jerk.
What he did do was...
That's out of character knowledge.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But what he did do is, each wager is for a section of life. As we had outlined earlier, life comes in a variety of packages. Or more to say, life is made up of a variety of things. Memories, your proficiencies, your desires, your dreams, etc., etc. Mm-hmm. And so, with each round, Michael would put something up for bet, and if he did not choose what that thing was to be put up for, it was chosen from amongst his materials for him. He put up a specific bet only on one specific fight, which was his soul. So for the first fight, he put his soul on the line, and he was successful. Unfortunately, he only beat a null. However, this was enough to, luckily for him, regain his physical body. So his body, technically, is alive.
No, Axel, that was not the first fight with a bet. That was the test fight.
Oh, that's right. Ooh, then you won even less. Unfortunate.
No, because I remember fighting something after the null, and then after that something, I remember fighting an ooze.
You fought the gnoll first as a test fight.
So wait, are you going to seriously tell me that for the second and final fight, you were making me fight a fucking Tarrasque?
Well, the first fight was still a bet. You just didn't run shit up on it. Every fight's a bet.
I said a test run, and he agreed to it.
You think you test run on craps in Vegas?
I mean, you do in your hotel room.
Now, maybe if you're in your hotel room, you could get away with that.
Okay, so I won the fight against the gnoll, which wasn't anything specified. So that's questionable of what I won there. And then same with the fucking ooze I beat.
Yep.
So you didn't specify two things he won?
Yep. Which means that the house gets to decide what he won.
Yeah. What did the house decide?
Luckily for him, the house has decided that he earned back his vitality, his dreams, which he didn't possess before, so now he is once again able to dream and sleep normally. Good for you, buddy.
Yay.
Unfortunately, these also come with some kind of flashbacks, I guess. So, for example, your vitality returned. Your original stats are now returned for your physical stats. So, fortitude, shit, is that the only one? No. Dexterity and strength are all now what they originally were before you were a mummy. Mm-hmm. And your memories count for a heavy portion of your mental effects, so they actually return the rest of your mental stats to the same. So your stats have now returned back to what they were before you were a mummy.
Awesome.
Unfortunately, you are still technically dead.
Yay.
But you can now have your ultra nice ranger skills back. You do also still possess mummy fist.
Yeah.
Let's see, what else were the changes? Let's see here.
Meanwhile,
so unfortunately what that does do is that removes some of the immunities and resistances that you had before, as well as the vulnerabilities. So you are no longer vulnerable to fire, and you are no longer resistant to piercing or slashing. You're still resistant to bludgeoning for now because you are dead. You are still immune to necrotic damage because you are dead, but you are not immune to poison because your body is alive.
Yay.
You are no longer immune to exhaustion, charm, poison, or frightened. But you are immune to paralysis.
Yeah.
Your other physical traits, like vision, should return to whatever they originally were. So if you had dark vision at a higher whatever before, you regain it. If not, then you lose it. You still possess your Dreadful Glare and your Rotting Fist attack. And unfortunately, you can still not receive healing in real time. You can heal with long rests in a more appropriate fashion, but you still cannot heal in real time.
Yay.
That's not good, though.
I mean, it's up and down. He just got his OP broken bow back.
But I can't heal him with my Cure Wounds spell.
That's fine. He's immune to something. Paralysis. Yeah, there we go. He's immune to paralysis and necrotic damage. He's fine.
I mean, and I'm resistant to bludgeoning.
I mean, to be fair, if really push comes to shove, what you could do is just cast a necrotic spell on him. Those give him temporary HP or regives HP back.
I don't have one of those.
Yeah. You could also technically just fix him with spells that are used to fix objects. Because a body is technically just an object.
I don't have one of those either!
Well then, sucks to be a bard!
In any case, so that is the that was the sum gain, because you technically won 3 matches, I think? Or was it 2 matches and then lost one? I gotta go back and look
at
this shit.
2 and then lost one.
Yeah, so you won 2 things and then lost one. Wait a minute. Alright, we have the knoll.
The knoll, the ooze.
No, you had a reptile.
Oh yeah, the reptile thing.
I knew
so
you
I
had
won 3 and lost one.
Yeah, the Tarrasque was always designed to be the third hard challenge, but that's why you did it. So you won 3 because you did get something for beating the gnoll, even though it's a test run. Because you can't go into a casino and not gamble. The risks were there. And because of that, the third thing that you had originally gained and then lost in the fight to the Tarrasque would have been... Damn it, one sec. I need to go look through the list of shit we had outlined. Because there's a list of it somewhere. God damn it.
Test run. Okay. So is that everything?
Memories, dreams, hopes, regrets, body, mind, decisions. Those were the things that we kind of outlined as a thing. You had already gained your memories and your body. You would have regained your memories. No, not your memories. Sorry, your mind and your body.
Mm-hmm.
So what you were going to get were your regrets.
Mm. Which might no regrets?
Well, it would explain why he kept jumping off the mountain.
Yeah.
Also, while you do sleep, you don't currently dream. Suck it.
Yay.
But yeah, that's the down low of what you have won and kind of lost, I guess, but yeah, whatever. And yeah, you wake up, you see these two, you talk to them.
Do you tell me all of that?
I didn't say shit.
Hell no.
Quick question, Axel. Do they notice Florence making that comment while listening to the
I mean, that's up to them. They're kind of in the middle of a thing. I feel like they're a bit distracted.
Which comment?
Nothing.
Real life, I did not hear you.
Oh, no. Real life, I had sent Axel a commentary.
Oh, okay.
Commentary that Florence could say.
So you did not tell me any of that?
No, why would I?
Because I'm offering you holy oil.
I have no need for holy oil.
You could put your arrows in it.
I shouldn't even be touching holy oil considering I'm undead.
That's true. I will fish out. I'll make it seem like I'm like digging around in my bag or whatever. Can I say I bought a bag? Because I don't actually have a bag. Just like a purse.
Mike.
Axel.
Sorry, one more time.
Remember, only Florence can understand him.
Can I say I bought a bag for like a gold piece?
Oh, in retro, you want to do that?
Yeah.
Well, okay, fine, I guess. Just to save us a little time.
Okay. So I fish around in my bag. It's just like a boring fucking brown bag. I fish around in it, and I pull out a single gold piece, and I say, "I'll give you this if you tell me what happened." It's all I have.
I mean, that sucks for you then, don't it?
Tell me.
Nah, I'm good. We're getting off this train.
Yeah, why are you still here, Florence? I thought you left.
I missed my stop.
You missed the stop?
Okay, if you sit here and laugh, then...
So, I guess the intelligent one's kind of an airhead.
No. I was... How about, you know what? How about
Mike.
Carly shares with you?
Mike.
Okay.
When did he say that statement?